隶书，
隶时代，
和均匀的线条比，它有的笔画有了明显的变化。
So you can see the balanced style and starting to have development not so balanced.
好，
我们继续做。
下面我们继续楷书。
And this equipment you can see is made of copper. In Chinese, we call it 正纸 to stabilize the paper.
对，楷书，它的笔画每一个笔画都规范化了。
So this is 楷 style. 楷 means model, and in 楷 style, each stroke.Is standardized. There is a fixed way of doing it. Chinese calligraphy is called 书法, the law of writing words, writing character. So you can see the law.Look at the strength of his hand.
你看那些点都在变化，有变化。
And you can see each point, each dot is different.
这里还保留了对称，但是它线条和它有不同的变化。
So the Li style, we still keep some of the balancing, keep some of the parallelness, but this one.Is not.
注意看，下面我写行书。行书的变化就是可以连笔，而且速度比较快。
行书 ，run style. Can see the speed is speeding up, and you can make some connected stroke.So some connected stroke, but still it's very readable. Much more freedom.
下面最后一个字，我要写草书。
The last style is the grass style, is the free.
草书的流动性更大，连。连笔更多，曲线变化也很大。
More movement. 好。Beautiful. This one has much more movement, liveliness, and it's like the bird flying, jumping, and it's really the ballet of our hands.
好，
谢谢，
现在请大家看一看。
OK.
这些，这就是我给大家讲的一个砚字的不同的书体。它的特点，从等线的篆书、均衡的，到隶书的笔画变化。到楷书的规范笔画，一直到行书的连笔简笔流动性，一直到草书的狂放，打破了原来的方块式的格局，将来我们看整幅的作品就更会明显一些。
So Mr. Jiang was speaking into explaining the style development.The original image, paralleled, starting to have some freedom, and standardized, more freedom, not exactly parallel, freedom, the most freestyle. 谢谢蒋先生，谢谢您，蒋老师。
好。
好。
希望大家喜欢它。
He hopes everybody will like it. Of course we like it.